Children, continue with the next topic, that is conservation of water. See, water is a very precious resource, so it should be conserved properly. Okay, and let us discuss some methods to conserve water. What are they? See, the first one is rainwater harvesting. It's a method of direct collection of rainwater from the rooftops of houses or other buildings. The rainwater can be collected during rainy season through the pipes in an underground tank. This will help to increase the underground water table. This stored rainwater can be used later for various purposes whenever we require. Nowadays, see, government also making it mandatory to have rainwater harvesting systems installed in every newly constructed house. So why that government is also making it mandatory? Because there are some benefits. Okay, what are those benefits? Increasing in the availability of the water and even improve in the quality of the groundwater. It is even environment friendly and helps in checking the decline in water table. And see students, it is not necessary that rainwater harvesting, however, that we are collecting those water from the rooftop, right? So the rooftops are flat also, as well as slope. Some of the rooftops are flat. In the desert areas, because of the heat is there, so that the houses are mostly built in flat, so there will be the rooftop also be in flat condition, ana. So that also be there, we can collect those rainwater. In some areas like that where there is snowfall and continuous rainfall, such areas the rooftops are slope, ana. Those areas also we can collect the rainwater, but see, from the slope itself the water is collecting, and there they made a construction like that this water can collect here itself before falling down and through that pipe and collecting in the tank. Understood? So the rainwater, whether it is in the flat rooftop or on the slope, we can store it. Okay. And the second one is efficient distribution of water. Here the water bodies from surplus water regions can be linked to those regions which face water scarcity. Linking of the rivers can help controls flood and utilize rainwater. Dams and other water reservoirs should be constructed in a planned manner to ensure the regular water supply. Here, see, what dams, everybody heard, right? And what about this water reservoirs? They are the large natural or the artificial lake that is used as a source of water supply. There the water can be collected and stored there. That a large natural or even artificial lake. Okay, that is known as the water reservoirs. And the third method is prevention of the wastage. Here, see, misuse and wastage of the water must be prevented. How is it possible, children? It is possible only when the individual, the community and the government make a joint effort, right? It is not possible by a single person. Everybody should think together. Control of population and new methods of irrigation. What are the new methods of irrigation? They are the drip irrigation and the water sprinklers. they can help conserve water in fields. Simply if you are supplying the water, it even some places it erode the soil also. So this drip irrigation slowly drip by drip, drop by drop, it gets the water into the and it goes into the roots of the plants. Okay, and these are the effective methods to prevent the wastage of water. And not only this, some more step also there that we have to take at our home. What are those steps we can take at our home? They are, see, use a bucket and mug for bathing instead of shower. So shower, if you are opening it, we need it takes much water, right? So if one bucket full of water if we filled means, so that much water we will use it, and right, with the mug, so there will be less wastage of water. And then even instead of cleaning the verandas or the quarters with the running water or with that hose, right, so we have to just mop them, that also be good. Then while brushing also, brushing the teeth, many of us are having this bad habit, right? When we are brushing, what as soon as we start brushing, we open the tap, then till it finishes we will think, sing something else we will do there, and till that the water continues, it flows. So what we have to do while brushing, do not leave the tap open, it must be closed. Then for even washing the vegetables, and that time those water, after washing the vegetables, that water we should not simply throw into the sink. No, instead of that, that in a vessel somewhere only we are washing, right, so that water we can use it for watering the plants, right? And even use in the toilets flush it is there na, so there also we can use a small pressure cistern tanks, so that we can prevent the wastage of water. Then repair the taps immediately, as soon as we found that the tap is leaking, then immediately we have to repair it. Okay students, so these are the conservation of water at home. And students, take care students, study everything whatever I taught you, and learn the things. Even though you have to read the chapter also very well. Okay students, take care.